Hello and welcome to F1 Livery Histories, the channel where we take a look back at the different paint jobs, racing trims and sponsor decals adopted by respective Formula 1 teams throughout the eras. Today we'll be taking a look at one of the most colourful teams ever to grace the Formula 1 grid. Benetton. The Benetton family's association with Formula 1 stretches back to 1983 when they first entered the F1 circus as title sponsors for the Tyrrell team. The following season, the Italian fashion company would return as sponsors of Team Alfa Romeo, and then finally Tolman for the 1985 season. During the 1985-86 off-season, the Tolman team was sold to the knitwear firm, who rechristened it Benetton Formula Limited. This unique purchase marked the first occasion that an international brand would oversee their very own F1 entry on their own merits from both a commercial and engineering perspective. Benetton's evolution into a fully-fledged Formula One racing team would pave the way for companies such as Andrea Merta, Red Bull and Virgin in years to come. So begins our retrospective on the racing liveries of the radiant and evocative Benetton Formula One team. The livery which put a new spin on the term paint job. The Benetton B186, powered by BMW turbocharged engines, was always going to turn heads upon its arrival at Yucca Rapagua for the team's maiden Grand Prix. The team's first Grand Prix car was painted deep green, Benetton's company colour, which encased the monocoque, as well as numerous other colours from the Benetton rainbow, such as blue, red and orange, which appeared on the white, canvas-like engine cover as brushstrokes, seemingly windswept by the rapidity of the moving car. The car also garnered more interest from the paddock with its bright multicoloured tyres, supplied to the team by Pirelli. Benetton's Sisley and Eurobags brands adorned the car's side pods and engine cover, whilst US airline Flying Tigers, furniture company Frisica, and Italian company Rilo also secured sponsorship with the team in their debut season. The bold new Benetton team celebrated its maiden Grand Prix win in its debut year when Gerhard Berger first crossed the line at the 1986 Mexican Grand Prix. The following season, Benetton switched to Goodyear tyres, mobile fuels and Ford turbo engines as the livery took on for the most part a four-colour palette, with red, blue, green, yellow and even pink isometric shapes meeting together on the bodywork of the B187. Sisley, Riello, Frisica and Eurobags were all retained as team sponsors, joined by Italian winemakers, Gunchia. In 1988, Benetton first secured a small deal with Camel, with the cigarette company securing real estate on the yellow engine cover of the B188 in place of Eurobags. The B188 retained the same four-colour palette from the previous season, minus pink, but with the colours divided into diagonal panels, which did much to enhance the visual appeal of the livery. The 1988 livery also marked the emergence of a hoop which ran horizontally across the nose of the car. This first hoop was painted red and occupied by Riello. The livery remained relatively unchanged in 1989, albeit with Gillette attaining a place on the side pods and 7-Up securing a deal which saw Benetton's traditionally black rear wings painted green. Japanese electronics company Sanyo and US watch manufacturers Bulova also jumped aboard as sponsors. 1990 saw Rotopolis, a recently constructed racing venue in Japan, secure a place on a car in a bid to promote the venue's intention of joining the Formula One calendar. Rotopolis logos adorned the car's side pods and within the front nose hoop, which was recolored blue. The rear wing of the car was also colored blue and came along with sponsorship from British newspaper The European. Benetton were now seen as an entrepreneurial and truly continental team. This fact was adequately reflected in the team's range of hip, new and innovative sponsors, as well as the effort the team put into its own marketing and branding off the track. Curiously though, the 1990 livery was bereft of Camel sponsorship, with the engine cover now featuring the United Colours of Benetton logo. However, the lack of Camel sponsorship would be very short-lived. In 1991, Camel joined on as title sponsors of the young and upstart team. The B191, with its raised nose, was now predominantly yellow in deference to Camel, whose logos appeared on the engine cover, the front wings and the rear wing. Autopolis retained their place on the side pods and the nose hoop. However, a lot of the team's smaller sponsors disappeared from the car, with only Sanyo remaining aboard from the season previous, who had acquired new space in the front wings. With the addition of their new title sponsors, the team's own company logos would maintain a smaller presence in 1991, appearing along the sides of the car's monocoque. The team also managed to weave their company colour of green into the livery, which created a touch of identity beneath the corporate colour scheme of Camel cigarettes. For races held in countries that had banned tobacco advertising, the blue Camel silhouette would appear on the car, sans text. 1992 heralded a switch from Pirelli to Goodyear tyres for the team, as the car remained kitted out in the yellow and blue of Camel. A host of smaller sponsors including Vival, USEN 440, LPR and Techno Gym would also partner the team in 1992. Autopolis disappeared from the side pods. The team would promote their own United Colours branding on the available space, which saw the side pods change to Benetton Green. The side pods remained green for 93, as Benetton used the space to promote more of its own brands, such as their ski wear lines, Castle and Nautica, Rollerblade, a subsidiary of Nautica, Prince, manufacturer and distributor of racket sports equipment, as well as the company's Killer Loop brand. These revolving sponsor decals varied from race to race, and became a trait that was uniquely Benetton. Autopolis had now completely withdrawn from the car, with Ford inheriting the place within the blue nose hoop. This was also the year the team changed to Elf Fuels, who featured on the car's airbox. The team also picked up additional sponsors in the form of Sulla, Osama, Denim, and Vaporetto as they continued their surge towards championship glory. Complete overhaul in 1994, not just in the technical world of Formula One, but also with Benetton as the team brokered a deal with Japanese cigarette tycoon Mild 7, now known as Mevius. The B194 Benetton Ford driven by Michael Schumacher to the first of his seven world championships featured a veritable cavalcade of shades, including Mild 7's colours of white, sky blue and royal blue, as well as the return of Benetton Green, which was once again seen on the side pods, as well as the nose and the front wing. The return of brushstrokes was also seen atop the car's side pods, as well as a dash of red on the very tip of the car's nose. Mild 7 was reprofiled as Benetton at races where tobacco advertising was banned. US computer company Oracle also joined the team as sponsors in 94, as did German beer, Bitburger. The two companies would share the car's side pods with the Benetton Group in another rotationally based deal. The livery is perhaps one of the busiest ever seen on a Formula One car, however, 1994 was a season of controversy for Benetton. Other teams suspected that the B914 was not legal due to the high competitiveness of such a comparatively underpowered car. An FIA investigation unearthed an illegal start sequence system in the car's onboard computer, but the governing body could not prove the systems had been used, and so the complaints were dropped. 1995 saw the team secure its first and only constructors' title, as Schumacher claimed his second driver's title in the now Renault-powered B195. Bitburger attained a permanent presence on the car's side pods, choosing to promote their non-alcoholic product, Drive, at certain events. RTL, Kickers and Flymo were included as team sponsors, whilst the team's title sponsor adopted the slogan Motorsport for certain races. The Italian flag now featured on the car for the first time, and with the change to Renault engines, the trademark blue nose hoop was occupied by the team's fuel supplier, Elf. With the departure of Schumacher and key technical personnel in 1996, the team and livery received a shake-up. In the absence of Bitburger, the Benetton Group once again painted the side pods green and promoted their own brands. Indian beer makers Kingfisher, Italian wheels manufacturers Fondmetal, and energy drink, Hype, joined the team, as the livery carried more amounts of white than seen before. The car was still distinctly Benetton though, as the brushstrokes, blue nose hoop, red nose, and Italian flag all retained their place. In 1997, FedEx, Gillette, Korean Air, and EDS all joined as sponsors, along with Akai, who reintroduced red to the car's barge boards. The team switched to Agip Fuels and ran factory Renaults for the final time in 3 years as the French engine supplier withdrew from the sport. This was the final year the cars were shod with Goodyear tyres. It was also the season in which the team would record its final Grand Prix victory, when Gerhard Berger, the same driver who had secured the team's maiden GP win, first crossed the line at the German Grand Prix. For the 1998 season, the team would go on to use redeveloped 97 Renault engines, rebranded as Playlife, yet another subdivision of the Benetton Group. Mild 7's sky and royal blue encompassed the upper part of the car, whilst the side pods of the car were white, to accommodate FedEx and Korean Air. The 1999 livery was an evolution of this, with Mild 7 now reading diagonally along the engine cover. FedEx had withdrawn from the team, replaced by Playlife, which was curiously stylized upside down. The loss of Akai saw the barge boards once again painted Benetton green. D2 Mannesmann also joined the team, appearing on the car's wings. The turn of the millennium saw the shades of Mild 7 feature much more heavily on the car. This mostly two-tone livery featured sponsorship from IT company Marconi, as well as the return of D2 and Korean Air. However, the Benetton team was sold in March of 2000 to Renault, who restructured the team in preparation for its return to Formula One as a constructor. The Benetton team was now Benetton in name only. And this was reflected in its final livery in 2001. The B201 featured none of the trademarks of previous Benetton liveries, such as the various coloured brushstrokes, the red tip nose, or any trace of Benetton's traditional green. Instead, the livery was completely painted in the shades of title sponsor Mild 7, who would continue to sponsor the Renault factory team. The team had also switched to Michelin tyres and Elf fuels, with Vodafone, Marconi and Korean Air also sponsoring the team during its final year as Mild 7 Benetton Formula. And so the curtain fell on one of Formula One's most fashionable and innovative teams from a marketing standpoint. Benetton will be forever remembered as a cultural team, a team of many colours, which was seen by the eyes of many all over the world in more ways than one.